So anyway, so here we are. So let's skip ahead to the part where So anyway, here's verse 16. What's it say? While he was yet speaking, he's talking about Job here. While Job was yet speaking, there came also another and said, "The fire of the Most High is fallen from heaven, and hath burned up all the sheep and the servants, and consumed them, and I only am escaped alone to tell thee." So here we have Job, not only was his children taken away, all his servants, in other words, his employees, man. He had a business going on. His business was his own self-employment on his own personal farm. And so he had hired hands, man. And they were all murdered by the fire from heaven. So it goes on and on. Sons and daughters were eating and drinking, and the house fell in on them. We had great winds come up, stunk them out, and all that. And so, what's Job say here after all this happens? Verse 21 of chapter 1. Let's see what it says. And we'll just go to verse 20. Then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down on the ground and worshipped and said, "Naked I come from the mother's womb, and naked I shall return thither. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." And in all this, Job sinned not, nor charged the Most High foolishly. Okay. But, you know, the thing here we don't see here yet is that it doesn't say. That we can read behind the lines here as it says, it doesn't say this. And Job has recognized that he's under the curse of the sin and he needs a savior. It doesn't say anything about that yet. It doesn't say anything about how Eve was tricked to be like the Most High and all that other good stuff. So, but we can read all that in between the lines once we know everything that's going on. All right, let's go to the next chapter. So here we go. Then verse 1, chapter 2. And there was a day when the sons of the Most High came to present themselves before the Lord, and we can insert the word here again. And Satan came also among them to present themselves, and the Lord said unto Satan, "From whence thou comest?" And the same old spiel, da 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 da. And the Lord said unto Satan, verse 3, "Hast thou considered Job?" Da 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 da. And Satan answered and said, "Skin for skin." He says, "Skin for skin, man." Let's see here. What's he say? Verse 4. And Satan answered and said, "Skin for skin, yeah. All that a man hath he will give for his own life. Skin for skin, man. Put forth thine hand now, Most High, and touch his bone." Woo! His bone and his flesh, and he'll curse you to thy face. And the Most High said unto Satan, "Behold, I'll allow you to do this." Although it doesn't say those exact words, that's what he's saying. Because Satan's asking permission. He says, "Hey man, touch his bone and his flesh, man." So who's touching his bone and his flesh? Or who's allowing it to be done? Ultimately, the Most High. So, the Most High is touching his flesh. But he's not the one causing the harm. The Most High is just allowing it. although the Most High is in all control of what's going on. Alright. The Most High allows Satan to touch his bone and his flesh. He says, let me touch his bone, man, and his flesh, and he'll curse thee to thy face. So anyway, he goes out there and strikes Job with the boil from the foot of his head, from his foot to the crown of his head, man. See there, verse 7? And then look what his wife says. So here's Job. He had to take a piece of pottery and scrape himself. And he sat among the ashes. And he said to, and his wife said unto him, listen to the old wife. Wife says, dost thou oh, come on, you friggin' cam twist. And his wife says, where is it at? No, verse 9. Verse 9. Then said his wife unto him, dost thou still retain thy integrity? Curse the Most High and die. But he said unto her, thou speakest as one as a foolish woman speaketh. What? Shall we receive good at the hand of the Most High, and shall we not receive evil? In all this did not Job sin with his lips? Now, when we're talking about sin here, we're talking about the sin nature. You know, complaining. That's all the sin nature. Participating in the sin, that's totally different. All right? And so, this story is here presented to us to give us a picture of how Job is, does not, how Job doesn't have a full under, doesn't have enough understanding about the sin. Let's just put it that way. Although he's never going to fully understand it because he's an Old Testament character. But the Most High wants to give him more insight. And as we read the rest of the story of Job, we come to find out the Most High says this to Job. Where were you? You know, the reason the Most High starts saying this stuff to Job is because Job starts growing impatient and the pain is starting to wear on him and he's starting to question everything. And there's a sentence in there, he starts to say stuff like, what have I done to deserve this? Alright? So he lasted a day or two, you know, and he didn't sin, he didn't complain. He didn't complain, right? Like the Israelites, you know, the Israelites in the desert, brought out from slavery from the oppressor. And then they started to complain when they were out in the desert. Oh, how we wish we had, using a witchcraft word, how we wish we had some food, the leeks and the cucumbers in Egypt. At least we had food, good food. We might have been slaves, but man, at least we had food and drink. We might have been whipped. They might have whipped us with the whip, but at least we had food and drink, man. We had fun. That was some good stuff, man. Good old food and drink, right? Remember those old Israelites? They started complaining. Ah! We don't have no good food and drink no more. Ah! And we might think today, you know, what a bunch of dumb, stupid Israelites. Complaining, you know, but if we were living back in those days, we wouldn't have been no different. We would have been complaining right with them. Ah, food! Ah! You know, and then when the Lord did give them food, he gave them manna, and then they complained about that.
Ah, this stuff is yucky! We want some birds, man! We want some fresh kill! Give us some bird! Ah, cuff or grip! Ah, I can use some fresh bird! Man! I'm tired of this cat food! Need a fresh bird!
So anyway, you know, that's all the sin nature. I said, yeah, I'm saying all this because that's just the sin nature. Complaining about pain, that's just the sin nature. That's just the sin nature, and that's totally different from knowledge of the sin. Knowledge of the sin. So the story goes on, and Job starts having a discussion with his friends. And his friends start telling him, well, maybe you did something wrong, man. Maybe it's something you did, you know. And Job starts justifying himself. I ain't done nothing. I ain't done nothing wrong, man. Shoot, man. I was praying every day. I was praying for my kids, man. I didn't lust after no woman. Didn't look at no woman. You know, I wasn't cheating on my wife and my mom. I wouldn't call my brother a fool in his mind. I says, man, I was keeping myself. I was being perfect. Basically, this is what Job is saying to himself. He's saying, I was being good, man. But the Most High wants to make a point to Job. And part of his point, the Most High wants to make to Job is that he ain't that good. He ain't as good as he's convincing himself he is. He's kind of lying to himself. He's kind of lying to himself. So, you know. And even if he just had the thought pass through his mind just for 1 second, he thought about that naked lady. Just for 1 second. Not that he thought about it, but just the simple fact that the thought came into his mind. Just the simple fact that Satan might have put that thought, or the Most High might have allowed Satan to put that thought, and that thought just went through for 1 second. The simple fact that that foul, nasty thought came in, right, is 1 second of proof. Not only to Job, but any man. That's 1 second of proof that now that man is guilty of the sin. And we might ask ourselves, well, how the heck does that work? Well, Satan was kicked out for trying to be like the Most High. Okay? Who can be like the Most High? Nobody. What is it that the Most High can do with thoughts? Right? Right? Those thoughts, that little 1 second little naked lady thought, that thought doesn't even enter into the Most High's mind, even for consideration for thinking about. So I'm saying, even though the thought came into Job's mind only for a, just say for a half second, and he didn't have time to even consider that thought or dwell on it. The simple fact that it came through, it won't even go through the Most High's mind. It don't even enter in. That's how perfect the Most High is. And that's a demonstration of how nobody can be like him. All powerful, all holy, all loving, all fair, all just. And this story here in Job is to show us is to give us a picture of